welcome. The latest news and headlines. Top Beijing official says that Sikkim standoff will not hit India-China cultural and economic ties. Supreme Court orders CBI probe into fake encounters in Manipur. In the Kerala actress abduction case, Dilip's wife Kavya Madhavan's business was raided by police. In France, Trump hits a U-turn on Paris climate deal he once called draconian. SS Rajamouli regrets talking about Sridevi's salary, says he made a mistake. The news in detail. The long-standing economic and cultural ties between India and China will not be affected due to a standoff between their armies in the Sikkim sector, a Chinese embassy official told in New Delhi on Tuesday. India and China have enjoyed historical and cultural connections over thousands of years, and be it trade or other relationships, we have been establishing ties. This border issue, I reckon, is temporary, and it will not affect our long-standing economic and cultural ties, the official said, on conditions of anonymity, as she was not authorized to speak to media. She was speaking on the sidelines of a pre-expo promotional event in Delhi. The troop impasse is in the Dokala area near Sikkim. Tension on the border built up after a Chinese army construction party attempted to erect a road in the region 3 weeks ago. Incidentally, India-China Economic and Cultural Council, ICEC, a non-profit organization which has been partnering with the local government of Dongguan City in China's Guangdong province since 2014 for annual event 21st Century Maritime Silk Road International Expo, on Tuesday renewed its partnership with the Chinese side to participate in the flagship event. Secretary General of ICEC, Mohammed Saqib, said in his address at the promotional event, "My dear Chinese friends, India is much bigger than what you see on TV screens. Don't believe what the private channels are showing you or the commentators they bring in for their shows. Most of it is rhetoric. Believe only what the Indian government tells or any of its ministers or foreign ministry. What unfortunate things you have been reading in media or seeing on TV, it is going to pass very soon. India and China have been friends and feel welcome in our country. And I tell the same things to Indian delegates planning to attend this exposition. Do not feel insecure." China and India have been engaged in a standoff in the Dokala area near the Bhutan Tri-Junction for the past 3 weeks after a People's Liberation Army construction party attempted to build a road. Dokala is the Indian name for the region which Bhutan recognizes as Dokalam, while China claims it as part of its Donglang region. China is also engaged in hotly contested territorial disputes in both the South China Sea and the East China Sea. Beijing has built up artificial islands and militarized many of them. Both the South China Sea and the East China Sea areas are stated to be rich in minerals, oil, and other natural resources. They are also vital to global trade. China claims sovereignty over all of South China Sea. Vietnam, Malaysia, the Philippines, Brunei and Taiwan have counterclaims. China also lays claim to tiny islands in the East China Sea between Japan and the Korean Peninsula and between Japan and Taiwan. The Supreme Court today directed CBI probe into various killing in Manipur under AFSPA. The Supreme Court will monitor the progress of investigation in these cases. The Supreme Court today directed the Central Bureau of Investigation to probe various cases of alleged fake encounters in Manipur. The Supreme Court also decided to monitor the CBI investigation. The court asked the CBI to file a compliance report in January next year. The Supreme Court ruling came during a hearing on a public interest litigation seeking probe into killings under Armed Forces Special Powers Act in Manipur. The apex court directed the CBI director to constitute a team within 2 weeks. The Supreme Court will monitor the CBI probe into various killings. The apex court was hearing a PIL seeking probe and compensation in alleged 1,528 extrajudicial killings in Manipur from 2000 to 2012 by security forces and police. A bench comprising Justices Madan B. Lokur and UU Lalit was hearing the matter. There are 35 matters related to Commission of Inquiry and 37 cases of judicial inquiry or High Court matters. These cases have been transferred to the CBI for probe. There are 23 other matters under investigation by the National Human Rights Commission, which should be heard along with 170 cases based on written complaints. The Supreme Court had earlier said that the state of Manipur would examine 265 cases and segregate the cases of Manipur police. Similarly, the Union of India will examine and segregate the cases related to the armed forces, including Army and Assam Rifles, the bench said. In the Keralan actress kidnap case, the main accused, Pulsar Sunny, has claimed that he deposited a memory card with photos of the kidnapped Malayalam actress at Kavya Madhavan's shop. In a new development in the Keralan actress kidnap case, pictures surfaced on Sunday of Malayalam superstar Dilip with prime accused Pulsar Sunny after the actor claimed he never knew the latter. The probe into the February kidnapping has turned murkier ever since the name of superstar Dilip got linked in the case. Not much headway has been made into the conspiracy angle, though those involved in the crime were arrested in a week's time. The latest pictures shown in TV channels on Sunday have come at a point when Dilip, during a 13-hour questioning by police last week, claimed he had no clue who Pulsar Sunny was. The pictures were taken at a club in Thrissur in November during the shooting of Dilip's film, George Chetan's Purem. Last month, Dilip's name surfaced in a jail inmate's letter who shared the cell with Sunny. Since then, Dilip is facing the heat. While Sunny and his accomplices were arrested within a week of the kidnapping, police stumbled upon the conspiracy angle last week. According to Manorama Online, Pulsar Sunny told the police that he deposited a memory card with photos of the kidnapped actress at Dilip's wife and actress Kavya Madhavan's online boutique, Lakshya, in Kakinada. A police team reached Kavya Madhavan's place of business and her home here to inspect business records and bank payments. On Saturday night, newly appointed Kerala Police Chief Loknath Behra reportedly expressed displeasure over the way the probe was proceeding. In an ambiguous statement, US President Donald Trump, who is in France right now, indicated that he could change his decision to pull the US out of the historic Paris Climate Accord. President Donald Trump held the door open to a reversal of his decision to pull the United States out of the Paris Climate Accord on Thursday, but did not say what he would need in return to persuade him to do so. Trump, who has made few friends in Europe with his rejection of the 2015 Paris Agreement and his America First trade stance, met with French President Emmanuel Macron as both leaders sought common ground to reset an awkward relationship. Trump has said the Paris Accord is soft on leading polluters like China and India, putting US industry at risk. Trump and Macron's relationship got off to a bumpy start, but both have an incentive to improve relations. Macron hopes to elevate France's role in global affairs, and Trump, seemingly isolated among world leaders, needs a friend overseas. Trump came to France beset by allegations of Russian interference in the 2016 US election, with emails released on Tuesday suggesting his eldest son welcomed an offer of Russian help against his father's Democratic rival Hillary Clinton. Weeks after Macron hosted Russian President Vladimir Putin at the Palace of Versailles, Trump will bask in the trappings of the Bastille Day military parade on Friday and commemorations of the entry 100 years ago of US troops into World War I. A woman was found murdered under mysterious circumstances in Lakshminagar in East Delhi. A woman in her early 50s was found murdered at a residence in Lalita Park area of Lakshminagar in East Delhi on Thursday night. The deceased was identified as Sangeeta Bansal, who worked at a PG. The incident came to light around 9:30 p.m. when Sangeeta's in-laws found the doors of her flat bolted from outside. As they opened the door, they found her in a pool of blood. Her body had multiple stab wounds. Her body had multiple stab wounds on neck and torso. Sangeeta was a widow. Her husband passed away 2 years back. Since then, she was living in a flat on the first floor of a two-story building at Lalita Park. Her brother-in-law was first to spot her body. He informed the police and then informed us about the incident, said Subhash Gupta, brother of the deceased. Sangeeta is survived by her two married daughters. Sangeeta's in-laws were staying at the ground floor, which has a separate entry. Police say they have registered a case of murder. It seems like people known to the deceased are involved. There are no signs of forcible entry. Also, two glasses of water were lying on the table, which indicate involvement of two or more people, said a police official. We have accessed the footage of CCTV cameras installed at nearby shops to identify the accused. The case is being investigated from each aspect. The assailants will be arrested soon, the official said. A case of murder was registered and the body was sent for autopsy, reports of which are still awaited. India's most anticipated film, Bahubali 2, The Conclusion, had an overwhelming response from fans across the world when it was released on April 28. Though Ramya Krishnan's performance deserves a special mention, the character Sivagami will be more remembered for the controversy associated with Sridevi and filmmaker SS Rajamouli. It's a well-known fact that Sridevi was initially approached for playing Sivagami's role. However, when the actress turned down the offer, reports were doing the rounds that the actor demanded a higher remuneration for the film, and hence the makers offered the role to Ramya Krishnan. Recently, Sridevi, while promoting her film Mom, said she was hurt by Rajamouli's comments and that the reports about her remuneration were baseless. Now, Rajamouli has responded to Sridevi's statements and has said that he made a mistake. According to a report in DNA, Rajamouli was quoted saying, "As for whose version to believe, I guess it is for people to decide. But one thing is for sure, I shouldn't have discussed the details on a public platform. That's a mistake and I regret it." He also added that, "I have huge respect for Sridevi ji as a flag bearer of the southern film industries in Mumbai for many years. I wish her all the best and I wish Mom a big success as the trailer looks very intriguing and promising." Rajamouli, in an interview to a regional channel, went on the record saying that the team was lucky that Sridevi rejected the offer to play Sivagami. Dengue prevention and awareness campaign was conducted in the Krishnagiri Government Higher Secondary School on Thursday. More than 3,000 schools took part in the campaign. In Krishnagiri, more number of people are being affected by the dengue, malaria, chikungunya and Zika virus. The district administration is taking many steps to create awareness about the possible diseases because of these viruses and awareness to prevent and safeguard against these illnesses. District Deputy Health Director Priya took part in a recent awareness campaign conducted in the Girls Higher Secondary School in Krishnagiri. She explained in detail about the Aedes mosquitoes and how to stay away clear and hygienic from any environmental factors that create these pathogens to live and grow. She advised the students to keep their houses and surroundings clean by getting rid of stagnant rainwater or sewage water. A concoction of neem leaves, Nilavembu, was given for all the students, which is a proven preventive medicine for dengue fever. The chief of the Differently Abled Integrated Federation Group, Raja, has spoken to the press reporters in Madurai regarding the fraudulent and pervasive activities in the equipments given to the Differently Abled under the MLA's fund.
எம்எல்ஏ திட்டத்தின் கீழே வந்து மதுரை மாவட்டத்தில் மிகப்பெரிய முறைகள் நடந்திருக்கு. அந்த முறைகளை வந்து நாங்கள் வீடியோ ஆதாரத்தோட மதுரை மாவட்ட கலெக்டரிடம் அளித்துள்ளோம். அதன்படி ஆடியோ விசாரணையின் மூலம் அங்கு நடைபெற்றது ஊழல் தான் அப்படின்னு சொல்லியிருக்காங்க. அதற்கான தக்க நடவடிக்கை எடுப்பதற்கான ஆட்களுக்கு அனுப்பி வைத்திருக்கேன்னு சொல்லியிருக்காங்க. இதுவரைக்கும் எந்த நடவடிக்கையும் எடுக்காமல் இருக்கிறாங்க. மாவட்ட ஆட்சித்தலைவரிடம் கொடுத்த அந்த முறைகேட்டு புகாருக்கு மாற்றுத்திறன் அலுவலகத்தில் எந்த ஒரு நடவடிக்கையும் இல்லாமல் அப்படியே கிடக்குது. ஸோ அது வந்து எங்களுக்கு வருத்தத்தை தெரிவிக்குது. இந்த ஆர்ஆர் அதாவது ஆர்ஆர் ரெமடிஸில் இருந்து ஆர்ஆர் ரெமடிஸில் தான் வந்து மாற்றுத்திறனாளிகளுக்கான உபகரணங்கள் செய்யக்கூடிய ஒரு ஒரு இது இருக்குது, ஒரு ஃபங்க்ஷன் நடந்துகிட்டு இருக்கு. ஆனால் அதே நேரத்தில் பார்த்தீங்கன்னா அவங்க அங்கே பண்ணாமல் சப்கான்ட்ராக்டில் மதுரை மாவட்டத்தில் உள்ள இரண்டு நபர்கள் மாற்றுத்திறனாளி அலுவலகம் இல்லாத இன்னொரு ஒரு இடத்து பழைய அலுவலகத்தில் போய் செய்கிறாங்க. அதற்காக சப்கான்ட்ராக்ட் வாங்கி இவங்களே பண்ணிடுறாங்க, பண்ணி முறைகேடு பண்ணுறாங்க. இது தவறு. இங்கே அங்கே இருக்க மின்சாரத்தை பயன்படுத்தி வெவ்வேறுதான் பண்ணுறாங்க. இதற்கு உறுதுணையாக இருக்கிறது வந்து மாவட்ட மாற்றுத்திறன் அலுவலர் தான் நாங்கள் நினைக்கிறோம். ஆனால் இதுவரைக்கும் 8 மாதம் காலமாக இந்த அறிக்கை மாவட்ட ஆட்சியரிடம் சென்றும் எந்த ஒரு நடவடிக்கையும் இல்லாதனால இந்த இதுக்கு நாங்கள் தள்ளப்பட்டிருக்கோம். அதாவது பொருளை வாங்காமல் வாங்கின மாதிரி செஞ்சு அதுக்கான ரெக்கார்ட் தயார் பண்ணுறாங்க. கைகால் இது இந்த கை பண்ணுறது. அதேமாதிரி உதாரணத்துக்கு பாருங்களேன், ஏன்னா இது வந்து என்னால் வந்து வீல் சேர் சார் ஒரு 700 வீல் சேர் வாங்குறாங்கன்னு வச்சுக்கோங்களேன். கொட்டேஷன் வந்து ஒரு 4000 ரூபா 5000 ரூபாய் கூட்டுறாங்க. ஆனால் 2000 ரூபாய்க்கு தான் வாங்குறாங்க. 2000 ரூபா அது என்னால் கொஞ்சம் டைம் முன்னாடி நிரூபிக்க முடியும். 2000 ரூபா ஆனால் ஒரு வீல் சேர் 2000 ரூபா கூட்டுறாங்க. இது மாதிரி நான் வந்து மதுரையில் மட்டும் அதை மாதிரி சொல்லலை, தமிழகம் முழுவதும் இது மாதிரி சப்கான்ட்ராக்ட் நடந்துகிட்ருக்கு. தமிழகம் முழுவதும் நடக்குது. மாற்றுத்திறனாளித்துறையில் ஏதாவது முறைகேடு செய்தால் யாரும் கண்டுக்கிறது இல்லை, யாரும் வெளியே கொண்டு வர்றது இல்லைன்னு ஒரு ஒரு இது இருக்குது. இன்னொன்று மாற்றுத்திறனாளித்துறையில் எப்படின்னா யாராவது பிரச்சனை கூறி ஆளானது இல்லை போட்டு விட்டு அப்படி சரி பண்ணி விட்டுரும். பொதுவாக அப்படி ஒரு இருக்குது.
And that's all for today's news. To watch more, please do subscribe. Thank you.